Hello, church. Welcome to the Wednesday night experience. Can you believe we're just 1 week away from Christmas? It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the time of the year we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, Prince of Peace, Mighty God, and Counselor. It's the time of the year we pull all the lights and decor out of the attic and go to town with ornaments on the Christmas tree. Wow, isn't it great? It's here in South Florida when we get those super cold 60-degree weather and we get to pull out our sweaters and boots for that one cold day. I remember just the other week as we were putting up our Christmas tree, our girls wanted to do Christmas lights outside, and I was feeling discouraged. I didn't want to do it, and I told them, I made a deal, if I plug in these lights and they work, we'll hang up the lights. And guess what? Sure enough, the lights went on. And they all worked. I'm so excited to be here with each and every one of you. My name is Richard Flores, and I'm here with my lovely wife, Sara Flores. And we'll be discussing the proclamation of Christmas of the newborn king. Wow, a new baby. There are people right now bringing home newborn babies as we speak. There are grandparents right now seeing these newborn babies for the first time, and a child is born. The past few weeks, we have been led down a series of passages that brings us to the birth of Jesus. First, Pastor Clyde and Pat spoke about the prophetic sounds of Christmas from Isaiah. Then Pastor Herb and Michelle Warden continue teaching about the promises of Christmas. Today, Sara and I we'll speak about the proclamation of Christmas. Let us pray for this service and join together with worship and song. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord. Father, we thank you for today, Father, for all you have given us. Father, we take this time and listen to your word and ask you, Lord, that you may open our hearts and minds to be receptive. Lord, we thank you for sending your son, Jesus, to be born, Father, at this wonderful time. That he may have died on the cross, Lord, and for our sins. And we thank you for that, Lord. Lord, teach and reach each and every one of the people that are listening and watching right now, Father. And we thank you and pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's lift our voice and lift up that familiar song as we sing joy to the world. Lord, we have a reason to shout. We have a reason to celebrate.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven, heaven. Sing.
What a wonderful song proclaiming joy to the world. Joyful, joyful. I'm Sara Flores, and it's an honor to be with you tonight, continuing this journey on the sounds of Christmas. As Richie mentioned, we'll be focusing on the proclamation of Christmas brought by the angels, the announcement of Jesus' birth. Please get your Bibles ready or download the Bible app to follow along as we look at this familiar part of Scripture. Now, as I think about births and the birth of Christ, all births are exciting. They're a joyful time that this new life is entering this world. Pregnancy is full of expectations, and a healthy baby and mother is such a wonderful miracle. So much time, effort, and money goes into preparing for a baby. In today's world, we get the rooms ready, we prepare by finding a doctor, designing a birth plan, even having a photographer on call for those adorable newborn moments. I know the birth of our daughters was nothing as we had planned. Both girls were delivered prematurely at 36 and 35 weeks. They were delivered by C-section. In fact, at our first daughter, Amelia's birth, the air conditioning in the hospital was broken, so we had a temporary air conditioning unit in our room to keep us cool. The funny part about that is my husband fixes air conditionings for a living. So even with the best design plans, births are not always as expected. And you can say that same thing about what happened at the birth of Jesus. Before we start tonight's text, let's review where we are in history to get a context of the scripture. This summary comes from Luke 2, 1 through 7. There was a census, and everyone has to travel to the ancestor's city to participate. Joseph, being from the line of David, was required to travel to Bethlehem. At this point, his fiancée Mary is heavy with child, the scripture says, and expecting to give birth very soon. Okay, now, we talked about birthing, now let's talk about pregnancy. Pregnancy is tough, especially that last trimester and that final month or days before giving birth. Although, as I mentioned earlier, I never actually got to that final month. But here is Mary walking, riding a donkey from Nazareth, where they lived, to Bethlehem. That's approximately 90 miles. When they finally arrive there, there's no hotel, no bed. They shelter in a stable with the animals in the hay. This is definitely not the pristine place for a baby's birth. This was surely not the plan Mary might have had in her mind. So now the story picks up in Bethlehem. And let's read the scripture, Luke 2, 8 through 20. And this is the New Living Translation. That night, there were shepherds staying in the fields nearby, guarding their flocks of sheep. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them, and the radiance of the Lord's glory surrounded them. They were terrified, but the angel reassured them. "Don't be afraid," he said. "I bring you good news that will bring great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David, and you will recognize him by this sign. You will find a baby wrapped snugly in strips of cloth lying in a manger." Suddenly, the angel was joined by a vast host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace on earth to those whom God is pleased." When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." They hurried to the village and found Mary and Joseph. There was the baby lying in a manger. After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished, but Mary kept all these things in her heart and thought about them often. The shepherds went back to their flocks, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was as the angel had told them. Let us pray for this word. God, we thank you for your word. Father, open the hearts and the minds of the people hearing today. God, that you may take this word and make it fresh for our hearts and minds, for our lives. Let the sound of Christmas be proclaimed as we read and study today. In Jesus' name, amen. We have a family devotion in our house at Christmas time, which our daughters read, that tells the story of Christmas from the shepherd boy's point of view. There's one particular portion of this devotion that we read recently, where it suggested your family to pretend to be a news reporter and to interview these shepherds on that night that they saw these angels proclaiming Jesus' birth. It was a fun night, full of laughter, and it actually helped in this preparation. So let's imagine, let's do that. We're in an open field as a shepherd when suddenly an angel just appears in front of you. Come on, come with me. Imagine it. Here we are in a field, in the dark, at night, with our sheep. We're watching over the sheep. Maybe one of us is tending to a hurt leg, caring for the young lambs, talking among ourselves. Maybe we're discussing about all these people that are coming into town for the census. Maybe we're talking about our political viewpoints. We don't know exactly what the shepherds were talking about, but it's fun to think about that. And then, suddenly, an angel appeared. The radiance of the Lord's glory surrounds. That light pierced the darkness. It must have been shocking and terrifying and definitely life-changing. Then the first sound of the angel's voice, "Don't be afraid." Probably settled like calm, like the wind calms. And angels always seem to have to say this when they say announcements. If you look back at Luke 1:13 and verse 30, and also it's in today's scripture, 2 verse 10. In fact, there are four angelic messengers in the biblical Christmas story. Now, last week, Pastor Warden went into some of these, but let's list them real quick. There was an angel that appeared to Zechariah, and an angel appeared to Mary to tell that she was going to bring forth God's son. An angel appeared to Joseph in a dream. And this fourth time in our story today, it was two of the shepherds in a field. I bring you good news of great joy to all people. The Savior, yes, the Messiah, the Lord has been born today in Bethlehem, the city of David. What a birth announcement. This was the proclamation of Christmas. And if we think about the ways we announce the births of our children, we send cards with cute pictures and smiling faces. We post pictures on social media. Some people plan extravagant parties either before or after the child is born. And this year was no different. Even with COVID-19 and things getting a little bit trickier, the creativity continued with drive-by baby showers, Zoom parties, and the list goes on and on. But the announcement that day by the angels in Bethlehem was a little different, and it definitely took the shepherds by surprise. After that first angel came and broke that darkness with light, a multitude, a vast host, a large number of these spiritual servants surrounded them, and that vast host rejoiced while singing, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased." Why were the angels singing and joyfully? Why did it take such a large host of spiritual warriors to come and deliver this message to these lowly shepherds? The angels were so joyful because they had an advantage. They knew this king that was arriving this night. They knew the hope that he would bring to mankind. They knew what the weary world did not yet know, that hope was coming, and hope was there. Hope was born and lying in a manger. This was a pivotal moment in human history, and this group of angels came together to declare the best news the shepherds had ever heard. What exactly did they proclaim? Good news of great joy to all people. This is the gospel message. The angels declared and proclaimed Jesus' identity, Son of David, Savior, the Messiah, Lord, the same message God spoke in Isaiah 9, the beginning of the fulfillment of the promises of God that God made to Israel through the prophets. This moment was the incarnation of Christ. God had taken on flesh and was dwelling among mankind, as referred to in John 1, 1-4. Again, this amazing birth announcement for the King of Kings. This proclamation by the angels and heavenly host was the perfect way to introduce this baby because God was now with us in flesh. In fact, baby Jesus cannot be separated from the Jesus of the rest of the Gospels. You cannot separate this birth story from the story of his life, death, resurrection, or lordship. The infinite was now inside this infant. Our salvation was in this infant. And if you really think about it, the miracles, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, it would not have happened without this birth happening this specific, unexpected way, and without the announcement given this way by the angels. Listen to this song, Glory to God in the Highest. Afterwards, Richie will return to continue teaching on the proclamation of Christmas.
Who could have imagined this? Infant and the infinite, Son of God, so wonderful, heaven's perfect miracle. Glory in the highest, glory in the highest, Prince of Peace, King of Kings, Jesus Lord of everything, glory in the highest. Born to die, born to save, sin away, light and life to all he brings. With the angels, let us sing. Oh, glory in the highest, glory in the highest. So peace, King of Kings, Jesus, Lord of everything, glory in the highest. Come and worship, come and worship, worship Christ, the newborn King. Come and worship, come and worship, worship Christ, the newborn King.
Who could have imagined this? Infant and the infinite, King of all, so meek and mild, God and sinner reconciled.
Glory in the highest, glory in the highest, Prince of Peace, King of Kings, Jesus Lord.
This baby literally changed everything. Bringing home our first child was nerve-wracking. I remember trying to finish the baby's room and Sara let me know that our baby was coming sooner than expected, 4 weeks sooner. As a frantic first father, I hurried to get as much done as possible. In fact, my brother-in-law was helping me put the crib together the same day our first daughter was coming home. Also, since we had a two-floor home, the bedrooms were upstairs, and pretty much everything we had upstairs had to come downstairs. That way my wife could manage as I had returned back to work. And it's just some of those things that come into play, as Sara said, as we put ourselves in that moment, as we slow down and dive into this time of the year and dive into these scriptures, that to think about what Joseph and Mary were going through. As Sara has mentioned, this wasn't a hotel. It was a barn with immense smell of animals, and it was just by the least, the cleanest place to be. But let me bring us back to the story. Now that we've looked at the angelic proclamation, let's look at the shepherd's response to this birth announcement. I'm going to read Luke 2, 15 through 20. When the angels had returned to heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." They hurried into the village and found Mary and Joseph, and there was a baby lying in a manger. After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished, but Mary kept these things in her heart and thought about them often. The shepherds went back to their flocks, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was just as the angel had told them. Thank you, Lord, for this word. The shepherds were terrified, but their fear turned into joy. As the angels announced the Messiah's birth, the shepherds received that joy and brought the announcement of the angels. What did they do with that joy? They spoke amongst themselves, possibly recalling the prophecies of Isaiah. And they went in unity to find the baby. They found Mary, Joseph, and the wrapped baby in the manger inside the stable, alongside the animals in this most humble place. Let's unpack this a little. First, the shepherds ran to see Jesus. Verse 15, they hurried, the word says. It doesn't stop there. The shepherds didn't stay in the presence of our Savior. This was bigger than them. Their joy and excitement was too big to keep to themselves. And again, just put yourself in that moment and enjoy what these scriptures are saying. So here it is. They find this baby that the angels told them about. And they were there, and they were so full of excitement that they couldn't stay still. They had to speak out that word. The angel impacted them so much that they had to make sure everyone heard of it. You know, as I hear of the proclamation and the sounds, I think of trumpets and horns and of the angelic hosts just preparing this announcement. I can only imagine being there. But it doesn't stop there. The shepherds didn't stay in the presence of the Savior, as I was saying. In 17 and 18 reads, "After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened, and the angel said to them about the child. All who heard the shepherd's story were astonished. Secondly, they spread the word. They spread it to others, the message of the Messiah's birth. This announcement and proclamation of Jesus was being shared. Light was spreading, illuminating the darkness. The same light was spoken in Isaiah 9:2, which Pastor Bailey had expanded on at the beginning of this month. Verse 20 again reads, "The shepherds went back to their flocks, glorifying and praising God for all they had seen, heard, and seen. It was just as the angels had told them. Thirdly, they continue sharing this message and birth announcement while glorifying and praising God while they worked. They probably shared it with anyone who would listen. They spread the sound of Christmas. So to wrap up, the proclamation began with one angel. The proclamation expanded to a multitude of angels announcing the birth of Jesus, the Messiah. After the angels proclaimed the birth of the shepherds, to the shepherds went on to find the baby. They were obedient and they found the Lord in a manger, wrapped in swaddling cloths, just as the angels proclaimed, just as Isaiah prophesied 700 years before. From there, the excitement and joyfulness grew. They went on and told more people about the child. The whole gospel is represented in the birth of Jesus. A baby is born in a stable, among animals placed in a manger. The proclamation from this heavenly host came to the shepherds, not city dwellers, not kings or priests. The birth of Jesus fulfilled everything spoken of him by the prophets, but not in the usual way. The baby Jesus grew to be a man of Jesus who led by serving, directed in humility, and reigned with power. The baby Jesus performed miracles, took on our sin at the cross, died and was buried and resurrected, giving you and me eternal life. John 3:16. So what are we to do with this announcement or proclamation? Can you proclaim the same in your heart? Is the Savior, the Lord, in your heart? Can you rejoice and excitingly tell others of Christ's child like the shepherds? If you do not have this proclamation or excitement already in your heart, now is the time. If you need to renew your proclamation, this is your time. We are here to shine the light and share the sounds that came into the world on Christmas. You can receive this proclamation of Christmas into your life today by asking Jesus into your heart. If you have not asked Jesus into your heart, you can do so today by praying with me. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, forgive me, Lord. Heavenly Father, come into my heart. Spread your light in me. I believe you are the Messiah, the Savior. And Lord, I ask for your forgiveness of my sins. Make me new. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen, church. Now, if you have just prayed this prayer for the first time or made a recommitment to the King of Kings, we want to connect with you. Please text FORGIVE to 954-951-4747. 954-951-4747. And we will send you a free digital copy, a resource, to help you along this journey of faith. We spoke a lot about joyfulness and spreading the light today, but we know that there are real issues and problems that we are facing in the world, and we want to pray for you. We want to pray with you and for you. We have a 24-hour, 7-day-a-week prayer line where you can reach us at, and that number is 844-680-7729. Thank you for worshiping with us and studying the word with us tonight. I hope this proclamation of Christmas has renewed, made a new meaning in your life. Merry Christmas and have a great day. year.